a generational issue that is calling for a response for what has been released upon our head to handle that giant. We are having so many giants in our generation presently. Giant of lies that is permeating the life of people. They are not living the truth, and it's time for us to begin to bring down all of these giants. David didn't call back. He didn't gather people. No, he began to respond with what has been released upon his head. He was having the fresh anointing upon himself dripping down from him. And that was why he was able to withstand every resistance until he was facing this giant. The Bible says he began to speak to this giant. And when he was finished speaking with him, he didn't even have time to listen to what the giant was saying. The giant was busy looking at him and saying, "Who is this little one? Am I a dog?" You may look as if what you are trying to do to the giant will look as if they are feeble efforts. He said, "You are coming against me with sticks. Am I a dog?" I want to let you know you shouldn't be intimidated at what the enemy is trying to use to intimidate you. Because right in you is what is contained that will bring down that giant. What he had looks as if they are weak tools. He has stones. He has stick. He has a sling. What can you do? You are asking, what can you do? What can you do compared to the giant facing you, the giant of deaths that are hanging, the giant of the issues challenging your life? I tell you this morning that the strategy God has given you, it is more potent. The Bible says, for the weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal at all. What David was holding was looking feeble, but they are potent. Because no matter what you have in your hand, if God breathes upon it, will bring down every mountain. It was just a rod that Moses was holding. He used that rod to sink the whole nation of Egypt. He was able to part the Red Sea with that rod. He was able to bring plagues upon a nation that was almost in charge of the whole earth at the time. But he confronted them with a feeble weapon. I tell you that in your hands you have a weapon. Just like David brought down that giant, I want to let you know in your hand is something that if you can trust God this morning, you are going to bring down every giant. You are going to bring down everything holding your life. You are going to bring down, I tell you. You are going to rise up, because it's no more time to negotiate. It's no more time to think about it. It's no more time to cry about it. It's no more time to keep on listening to all the taunts of the enemy. Some of you crying in the night and wondering, how is God gonna do this? And the enemy have been seeing your tears. The Bible says the whole land of Israel, we are trembling. Whenever Goliath comes out, the Bible says they will melt away. All of them we are dodging. We knew about Saul. The Bible said that Saul was a man that was so tall in all of Israel. He was a shoulder taller than every man in Israel. But he confronted a giant that made him look like a dwarf. Oh, I tell you something. It doesn't matter the size of that situation. I don't know who you are hearing me this morning. It doesn't matter the size of that situation. What is important is the thing that is in your hand. If you can recognize that God has placed the most potent weapon. The Bible says the weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal. They are mighty through God to the pulling down of stronghold. I tell you something. What killed David, as you heard, is not this. What killed Goliath is not the stone. What killed him was the power of faith. When he took into action what he believed God to do, you know what happened? That giant fell on his face down. That stone hit his forehead, but he fell face down. To let you know, it is not our effort that is giving us the result. So stop trying to calculate your effort and step out by faith. That situation that looks as if it is trying to sink your life, that situation that looks as if you don't know what is gonna happen, don't despise it. That don't, I want you to look into the it and begin to see the faith that God is expecting you. He said all things are possible to him that believeth. What God is going to use to bring out that giant may look insignificant. Don't ever allow the enemy to despise the tools in your hands. That was what David did. David was not scared when you were telling him, am I a God? You are coming after me with a sword. You are coming after me with a stick. And he was calling it a stick. It was the shepherd's staff that he had in hand. He did not let it down. He was holding the shepherd's stick. He was holding the bag of the shepherd bag. He was holding the sling. I tell you, these are ordinary tools.
Yes.
But God used it as he went out in faith. I want you to believe God in faith that God is going to use what you have in your hand to bring down the giant of your life, because this 17th day, I see the Lord using the insignificant things around you, the things that look as if they are not, you know, that is the things God is going to use to bring down every giant. What brought down the Goliath giant, you know what brought it down? It was nothing. It has nothing to do with what David did. Because he fell face down. You can't hit somebody and he'll fell towards you. He have to fell down. It was not the force of that stone that brought down Goliath.
It was the
but
force.
But I tell you something, there is another thing I noticed in that story. You know what? When David was going, he did not go with the armor of men. He did not go with the armor of the flesh. He didn't even have a sword. He was coming. It is not a movie, it's not a cartoon. I'm talking about a life situation. He went out in the name of the Lord. He did not carry any sword, but he was sure he's going to come down. I want you to look at that situation and trust God. You may not have what the world will call the right equipment, but if you trust God, the Bible says that when David brought him down, he climbed upon this giant. Yes, he has slain him, but he needs to cut off the head. He had no sword in his hand. He had to take the sword of the enemy.
Yes.
There is something in the hand of your enemy that you need to bring him down. And as you are going out by faith, the battle is the Lord. The battle is not yours. And I tell you that same God who did it in the life of David is about to show up in your life today. This 17th day, hallelujah.
Amen.
I see you rejoicing because the battle is turning out to your favor. All those things that are so scary, they are so big, you don't know how you're going to do it in this 17th day of this fast and prayer. The Lord is rising on your behalf. He is making you to understand there are things in your hand you're going to use to bring down the giant. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
It's in your house. I keep hearing that. It's in your house. When we say it's in your house, it doesn't mean it's in your house literally. Yes, it can be in your house literally. The Bible said that this woman, the widow, cried to the prophet and said, they are about to sell my two sons. Mm. They are about to sell my two sons. Prophet, help me. And he said, what do you have in your house? The woman said,